someone rejects the hadith and makes him kafir. But if someone rejects the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which is authentic and which is sahih, and we cannot label anyone a kafir, because we have to know why is he rejecting, what is the reason. So maybe he has in his own logic, because the one who is being called kafir is simply who just simply rejects from his head that I do not accept it. I don't care if the Prophet said that. That person is a kafir. He's a fool. He's out of fold of Islam. He's not a Muslim. But if someone has a different logic and a different interpretation of the hadith, and interpretation other than the Sahabas, or has a different interpretation, we have to know why is he rejecting, or maybe he has a lack of knowledge, and maybe he is not understanding. He has to sit down with the scholars, and he had to get the more knowledge about the hadith, because there's a whole complete science in the hadith, which is the hadith of the science of the hadith, and they have to know exactly why they are rejecting a hadith, because we cannot just like label anyone a kafir, because someone has to exactly like declare the faith that I'm rejecting this and I don't care and I'm simply do not accept this. So that becomes like an for his out of fold of Islam. Regardless, he labeled himself as a Muslim, he was born a Muslim, it makes him a kafir, because who rejects the Prophet ﷺ's teaching, it makes him a kafir. But one who just rejecting because he doesn't have knowledge, he does not have a proper research on the particular hadith, and it could be many issues that he has not researched, that he has not studied the translation of the tafsir of the Quran, and he has not studied the hadith, so that does not make him a kafir. But simply somebody rejecting a hadith, everyone has to know like why is he rejecting that, because if he's rejecting that, then he's not if he's rejecting that, then he's considered as a kafir. But if somebody is rejecting, but someone before labeling anyone has to know why is he rejecting the hadith, if it is authentic. He could reject the daif hadith, that's fine, it's acceptable. If somebody is rejecting fabricated, he has to reject that hadith, because maybe there's a sect who is being rejecting the person, considering him as a kafir, because he's rejecting the daif hadith or the fabricated. He does not make him a kafir. The kafir is the one who has to declare his faith that I'm not accepting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam this teaching and that teaching, because this beautiful line in the Holy Quran, the verse chapter 2, verse number 208, where Allah says, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu udkhulu fis silmi kaffatan wa la tattabi'u khutuwatish shaitan innahu lakum aduwwun mubin." Where Allah said, put yourself entirely into the fold of Islam and do not left any part for shaitan, that he can deceive you with his own logic. So rather we should not go for logic, but rather we should get understanding, get an education from our scholars to understand about the hadith. But calling someone a kafir based on somebody just like simply rejecting a hadith, we should not call him a kafir, because we don't know his intentions, we don't know what's in that, because it is only Allah who is alimu bi zati sudur. He is the only one who knows what's in the heart. So we should not call any Muslim a kafir.